Good morning, students. So, in our previous class, we have discussed about the sampling technique, pulse code modulation, pulse position modulation, all other kinds of modulation techniques. So, today I am starting my remedial class on the topic of quantization. So, before understanding the quantization, we know that the first step for any signal conversion from continuous time signal to discrete time signal is gone through using the analog to digital converter. So basically, analog to digital converter conversion is a three step process. The first part is sampling, the second part is quantization, and third part is coding. So we have learned about sampling in our previous lectures. Today we will talk about the quantization technique. So basically, this is a time frame for any analog to digital converter. First of all, you have to take the analog signal, then analog signal, the definition of analog signal, it is continuous in time and continuous in the amplitude. For example, our signal xt is equal to sine 2 pi ft, where t can be taken as 0.1, 0.11, 0.12, and so on. So this is continuous in time and continuous in the amplitude. So this is the definition of the analog signal. All natural signals are analog signals. So first of all, you have to use the sampling techniques. You learned about the Nyquist criteria and all other things. So after that, you get a sampled signal. Sampled signal, the definition of the sampled signal is it's discrete in nature. For example, your signal, when you give a xt, you will get a xn. That xn is equal to sine 2 pi fn and ts. Okay, ts is the time interval. So for the discrete signal, the excess time is in discrete form, but the amplitude is again the continuous form. So this signal, this continuous amplitude and discrete time signal xn is fed to the quantization is a process done by the analog to digital converter, that is quantizer. It is also known as a quantizer, and output of this quantization you get a signal. This again digital signal. Your time is discrete, and in this time your amplitude is also discrete. So this is the basic definition of difference between the digital signal and the discrete signal. In discrete signal, your time is discrete but amplitude is continuous, but in digital signal your time is discrete and amplitude is also discrete. After that, you fed to the binary coded system and you get a binary values. So the digitization of the analog signal involves the rounding of the values which are approximately equal to the analog value. This process is done in this quantization process. The method of sampling cues of a few points on the analog signal, and then these points are joined to round off the values to near the stabilized value. Such process is called the quantization. We will further understand the definition of the quantization. So when digitizing, the first step is to sample the signal to regular intervals. We learn about this. The next step is the quantization. It gives a finite discrete value to the samples. Okay, the device that perform quantization is quantizer. Basically, it's an ADC. It takes the sampled input and generates a quantized input. We'll learn about that. Both the sampling and the quantization results in loss in the information. This is a very important one. What has happened? Because the analog signal is continuous in nature. Continuous in nature means for every time instant. For example, t is equal to 0, 0 to 0.1, 0.11, 0.111, you always have a value. So for each time instant, you have a value. Means the information is full. But when you do sampling and quantization in both form, your x-axis, this is the continuous axis, is split into discrete signal and discrete axis. So in the discrete itself, you have a value at a certain time in interval. You do not have a value in between two consecutive time interval. Okay, so there is a loss of the information. So loss of the information results from both sampling and the quantization. So this is the point here. The both sampling and the quantization results in loss in the information. The quality of the quantizer output depends on the number of the quantization level. This is again, we will discuss it later, that how the quality can be improved by increasing the quantization level. For example, the more number of the quantization number, then more information is inhibit that signal. The space between the two adjacent quantization level is called the step size. So this is your continuous signal, analog signal. एनालॉग सिग्नल एंड दिस इज योर क्वांटाइज सिग्नल. क्वांटाइज सिग्नल फॉर एग्जांपल इन दिस इज फॉर अ 3 बिट क्वांटाइजर. फॉर अ 3 बिट क्वांटाइजर यू विल हैव अ 8 क्वांटाइजेशन लेवल. सो फॉर 3 बिट क्वांटाइजर दिस इज 8 लेवल 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 0 to 7 that is 8 quantization level. So our signal is split into 8 part. Okay, in below line the dashed line dashed line is representing the quantization level. Okay, 3 bit quantization there are 8 quantization level. So it is also called as the staircase of waveform because of this waveform shape. So type of the quantization, basically there are two type of the quantization process, that is uniform quantization and the non-uniform quantization. So the equation to and one important equation that put in equation to find the step size is given by the x maximum minus x minimum divided by l, where x maximum is the maximum value of the signal, x minimum is the minimum value of the signal, and l is the number of the levels that divided the signal. Okay, this is a very basic formula. So first of all, what is uniform quantization? The uniform quantization, as the name implies, the uniform quantization has an equal spacing between the quantization level. Further, it can be broadly classified into two types, that is mid-thread and mid-rise quantization. So both of these are the symmetrical about the origin. In the mid-thread quantization, the origin lies in the middle of the thread of the staircase graph. The quantization level mid-thread are in odd number, whereas in the mid-rise quantization, the origin lies in the middle of the rising part of the staircase of graph. The quantization level in the mid-rise are even number. So this is the mid-rise type uniform quantization. Okay, the origin lies in the middle of the thread. This origin is like middle of the thread. This is a thread, middle of the thread, and in mid-rise it is horizontal. This is vertical part, this is horizontal part. Mid-thread is this one is mid-thread, it's a horizontal part, and mid-rise is rising part in the vertical axis. Okay, it has a odd number of levels and it has an even number of the levels. This is the basic difference. So what is non-uniform quantization is in non-uniform quantization the step size is unequal. This is about the quantization error. We will discuss this little bit later. So what is the difference between the uniform and the non-uniform quantization? The uniform quantization is the type of the quantization in which quantization levels are uniformly spaced, as the name implies, whereas the non-uniform quantization level, these are unequal or non-uniform. Moreover, the uniform quantization has some amount of quantization error, but the non-uniform quantization reduces the quantization error. This is very important and we will discuss this later, that why uniform quantization has more error than the non-uniform quantization. So in summary, the uniform quantization, the type of the quantization in which the quantization levels are uniformly spaced, is uniform. In non-uniformly spaced and non-uniform, categorized as further categorized in mid-rise and mid-thread, and does not categorize quantization error as a some amount of quantization error, reduces the quantization error because of the non-uniform. So this is an example of reconstruction of transition level of a uniform quantization. So as you can see that if the we have increases the number of the quantization, for example this is 2 level, this is 4 level, this is 8 level, 16 level, 32 level and 256 level. So as we increase the level of the quantization, the information is in this picture is increases, or as the information is increases, the picture quality is improved. So for less number of this quantization level, the image's quality is not proper, it has more error, and when we increase the level, then we have a better view of this picture. This is a non-uniform, and again this is a uniform quantization of 4 level, again non-uniform quantization of 4 level. Both the levels are the same, but the quality of the picture is more in the non-uniform quantization, because in non-uniform quantization the step size is increased decreased based upon the information. So it is non-uniformly, where the more information needed, the step size is decreased, so more information is fed to the system, so picture quality is improved. Whereas in uniform, all this picture is treated equally, uniformly. So that's why that there is a loss of the information. And again comes this quantization error. For any system during its function, there is always a difference in the value of this input and output. As we all know, the processing of the system results in an error, which is difference of those value input, and the difference between the simple the difference between the input and the output is known as the error. The difference between the input value and its quantized value is called the quantization error. A quantizer, which is basically ADC, is a logarithmic function that performs the quantization of the raw window value. So this is your signal, this is your quantized output, this is your quantized output, quantized signal, and this is your quantization error. This represents the quantization error. For this point, at this point, the quantization error is zero, and then it increases and decreases based upon this information. And what is quantization noise? Quantization noise is similar to the quantization error, but is usually occurs in the audio signals. So for example, in music, the signal keeps changing continuously, whereas the regularity is not found in the error. Such errors create a wide band noise. It's called the quantization noise. Noise is what is unwanted signal. It's termed as the noise. So next topic is very important topic is for as per the university point of view, the compounding in the PCM technique. The word compounding is a combination of compressing and expansion, which means it does the both. That is, compounder does the both compression and expansion. So compounder is a compressor plus expander. This is a non-linear technique used in the PCM, which compresses the data at the transmitter and expand the same data at the receiver. The effect of noise and the crosstalk are used using this technique. So it is basically compressing and expanding the data, compressing at the receiver end and expanding at the transmit again. So there are basically two types of the compounding technique, ALOR and ULOR technique. What is ALOR compounding technique? A uniform quantization is achieved when A is equal to 1, where the characterized curve is linear and no compression is done. ALOR has a mid-range at the origin, hence it contains a zero, a non-zero value. ALOR compounding is used for PCM telephone system. So this is the basic formula for ALOR compression. ALOR compression is given by this FX. You have to learn this formula. You need not to go through the basic derivation of this formula. You just need to learn this formula. This is for the compression. This formula is for the compression at the receiver side, where X is the input signal. Sigma is the sign of the input signal, maybe positive or negative. Mod X is the absolute value, and A is given by 87.6 by the. It's a fixed by parameter by the Consultative Committee of the International Telephony and Telegraphy. Then next is the ALOR for the expansion. This is at the receiver. Then this one is the receiver end. This one at the transmitter end. The receiver end. It is inverse of XY, where FY is the compounded signal and given by this formula. You have to learn this formula. Okay. Then the mu law of the compounding, the uniform quantization is achieved by at mu is equal to zero, where the character curve is linear and no compressing. The mu law has a mid thread at the origin, hence containing a zero value. Mueller compounding is used for speech and the music signal. It's basically used in North America and America. This is again for the Mueller for the compression and the expansion. This equation is given by where X is the input signal, Y is the compounded signal. Sigma is the sign of the input signal and sign of the compounded signal is absolute value of the X, absolute value of the mu is equal to 255 is the compression parameter defined by the CCIDT. So in compounding, the rate of the compression depends on the value of the compression parameter mu and the A, and of the equation represents the section of the logarithmic compounding curve. The greater value of the compression parameter, the higher rate of the compression. So these are the two basically comparison graphs. Okay, this is for the mu law and this is for the A law. If mu is equal to zero, it's a straight line. A is equal to zero, it's straight line. Just put the values of mu is equal to zero and A is equal to one in this equation, then you will get all these values. Okay, these curves are originated. So thank you for today's class. In today's class, we discuss about the quantization and the compounding technique. So I hope you understand all the concepts of the quantization. Thank you for joining me in the media classes.